Hello and welcome back to another episode of the Royal Family. In the last episode, we got to age up Princess Amira. She had her huge birthday party with all of her relatives and friends, and we got to see them all again. And we also got to play around with some of her hair and the custom content we have for the kids as well. So we got to choose her outfits, and what we chose, I like a lot. I definitely think that it's good for Princess Amira. We also chose her trait to be hot-headed. We know that she's going to be a little bit of a spoiler princess. She's the oldest out of all of her cousins in the royal family, so she's definitely used to having the attention on her. She's used to being bossy, so she's got quite a short temper, so that's why we went with the hot-headed trait. She also joined a kids club, and she's going to meet a lot of the other noble family's children that are her age. So in this episode, we're going to focus on her being in that club and seeing how she interacts with all of the kids, seeing if she's going to be a good follower because she isn't really the leader of that group. I also did get a few different mods, and I finally figured out why my mods and custom content were showing up. They were in this little subfolder in the folders, and I thought that it was okay because they were just like in one folder, one level down, but apparently that wasn't okay, so none of them were showing up. But that means that I got like all of my custom content that I thought I had found and downloaded. It's all there now, and I'm so excited, guys. I'm so excited to show you guys this. And now that we have our mods, we have the Master Command Control Center, I think that's what it's called, so I'm really excited to play around with that today with you guys as well. Before we begin today's episode, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and turn on your notifications so you're notified when we post a new video. Don't forget to follow us on social media so you can interact with us and help us with our storyline, and let's go ahead and begin today's episode. So the very first thing I want to show you guys today is one, I listened to some of you and downloaded custom content skin and eyes, but I'm confused because I thought I downloaded a few different custom content eyes, but now everyone has custom content eyes. So I have to zoom in and show you guys. Well, she's looking up right now, so you can't really see, but they all have these glistening eyes that I'm not used to, guys. And I tried to change it in there in like the Cass, but I couldn't figure out how to change their eyes. So if you guys know how, please tell me. I thought I downloaded multiple eyes for them. I like went to go look in the eye colors and see if it was there, but it's not. I also checked makeup, but I don't think it was there either. So I'm very curious because now everyone has these eyes. So I don't know if it's just like a default thing or what, but it's gonna take some time for me to get used to them. I also changed Princess May's hair. So she had the two little pigtails before. So technically she got a haircut, and now she has this cute little hair. And like, guys, though, her eyes, they're so dark. I think I need to change her eye color because it's kind of bothering me a little bit that they are like, they look like little black holes. They look a little freaky. I think I'm going to change that. But I did change her hair. I changed Princess Amira's hair from the last episode when we chose her outfit. So this is more similar to the hair she had as a toddler, and that's what I wanted. I wanted it to be very similar with like the gorgeous waves and the big curls that her hair half up, half down with the bow. So I'm so excited she has this hairstyle now. I think it's much more her. And another big thing is that I finally found the formal outfits for the kings, and we finally found a purple one. So you guys have to tell me what you think about this because it is a lot. It is a lot. I mean, look at this, guys. This is just, I mean, this is what I was looking for though. I was looking for something as elegant and large, I guess, as that crown is, because that crown is huge and I couldn't find an outfit that went with it because all of the outfits that we thought would go with it were just like, the crown looks so big compared to everything else. But this outfit makes the crown look somewhat normal. It's just, it's so much. It's so big, but I'm so glad we finally found a color for us, because everything else in the custom content was like black, or it was red or blue, but we couldn't find any purple or pink. So I finally found a purple outfit for our King of Windenburg. I also have a party outfit. I don't know how I feel about this. This is just a top, so I don't think I downloaded the pants that came with it, so I need to do that. And I think then it would match a lot better. But this, it's not purple, it's not our colors, it's gold, but I don't know. I thought it was nice enough. We don't have as many options for the colors for Windenburg as we do with the other kingdoms, because their colors are more common, especially the royal family of Willow Creek. Their colors are blue, and there's just so much blue going on, so we definitely have a lot more options for them. Okay, I'm going to send them off to work. Princess Amira is going to have school, I think. Oh, does that mean she needs to do her homework? She should definitely do her homework. All right, what? Why doesn't she have class? She has class in 2 days? She doesn't have class today? That's very odd. I feel like all the other kids are gonna have class today though, so I don't know if we're supposed to get together with them. I'm not going to invite any more of them in. Well, you know what? No, I got that mod where you can add more club members to it. So let's see. We already have the maximum available though. I can select up to 14 Sims to add. Oh my gosh, yes, guys. I'm so excited we got this. Oh good, now we can have like all of the royal cousins in a club when they all turn into kids. Good. I'm so excited for that. I guess we can add the other ones then if we want to. We can add two. We'll just add like the royal ones for now. So I'll add Sir Sean Windenburg and Sir Ian Willow. I haven't even met any of these kids yet. So I need to. We don't focus too much on the noble families. So we should probably do that a little bit more, but I like focusing on the royal families. It's so complicated and it already keeps us busy enough. I don't even know if we need to bring the noble families into it unless they're marrying one of the royal family kids. So I don't know. It's just a lot to deal with. Look at her just sitting here like a lady though. She is just minding her own business. I also got pose packs. So I want to do family portraits. So I'll have to see how that goes. Okay, her eyes are bothering me. So I'm going to go change that because they look like little black holes, guys. She kind of looks like a little demon and it's bothering me. I don't know how. I guess if we just made them white. I don't like changing their genetics though. I really like them having what they got from their parents. So I'm kind of disappointed to be doing this. But it needs to be not so dark. It's just, it's a lot. It does, and they're not even, like, her eyes aren't really that dark when you look at it up close. But when you're looking at it from far away, they just look like little black holes, and it's not, it looks a little creepy. I did get some skin details, too, because a lot of you were telling me to do that. So, whoa, what? What is this? Why are they different colors? What? What? What just happened? Oh my god. Oh, whoa. Okay, that is pretty cool. I thought I got more skin details, but I guess not. If you guys have like a favorite skin detail, please drop it below in the comments, the link, and I would love to download it because I don't even know what I'm looking for skin details. This is kind of new to me, guys, so bear with me. So we are going to change, I guess, her eye color. I like that she has gray eyes because her mother has gray eyes. Maybe if we just do like a lighter gray. This doesn't even look that much lighter though. Why can't I change the fact that she, I think I'm just gonna have to download other eyes then. Because I don't know why. This is confusing to me. This is all extremely, extremely new to me. All right, this looks less like black holes, so that's okay. And then I'm also going to change Princess Amira's eyes. So that is the original, and then we change it to that. And that is definitely lighter. You can see that. Do we need to change their brother's eyes too? I think we do. I think we need to change all of their eye color. That's fine. What color eyes does he have? He has a little bit different color eyes than his sisters do. That's really, really cool. Okay, so we have changed all of their eyes. His still look a little creepy though. They look a little strange. This is Princess Alice. I added eyelashes to her. She has the eyes that I can't get rid of apparently. I don't know how. And then she has like custom content makeup. So I'm starting to get more custom content makeup and skin details, guys. So hope you guys are proud of me because I don't usually do this, but I think King Henry's okay. He's all good. Okay, we're going to go back and then I guess we'll just start a club gathering. If the kids are at school, I'm pretty sure they'll come anyway, so they can all just miss school. That's fine. Okay, so the kids are home. I guess I'm assuming the butler is... Oops, I did not mean to take a screenshot. I'm assuming the butler is here because I don't think that they would leave Princess Amira to babysit the toddlers unless they really, really trust her. Our butler is for sure here. I should probably have Princess Amira introduce herself to him. Oh my gosh, now I have all of these other choices now that I'm not used to. I'm scared I'm gonna click on one of them. Oh, it looks like she does know him though. Yeah. Oh no. No, it says that she doesn't. Why can't she introduce herself to him? If she does that, it would get her manners up, because we're gonna need to start working on her manners and all of that, like her responsibility. She'll need to start setting the table and stuff, even though I don't even know how much responsibility she would have, because I said that Princess May is the wild one, and she is, that's her trait, but she's going to be, I'm pretty sure, like more of a tomboy, but I feel like Princess Amira is also a wild one in a totally different way, so it's just really interesting to see how they're gonna turn out. I kind of wanna get some more mods and add different traits too. I think that would be pretty cool. So Princess Amira is talking to the butler, and then let's go ahead and start a gathering, I guess. We can have everyone over here. So all of the kids are going to be here in just a moment. So this is kind of, I guess, the first time really meeting all of them. Also, why does it take them way less time to appear when they're meeting for a club gathering than it does when they're meeting from a party? Because they all just appeared here, but when they're meeting for a party, they all come from back here. It's so strange. I don't know why they do that. Oh, shoot, we need to pay our bills. Okay, a new challenge. King Henry IV needs a new challenge at work. How does he ask the boss? Present suggestions. Don't demand it. Okay, yeah. Medium performance gain. Good job, King Henry. Okay, so let's meet everyone. It's gonna take way too much time to change all of their outfits, but I'm gonna need to do that at some point because I don't like their outfits. I thought we had a lot of kids in the royal family, but there are so many more other kids out there in the noble families too, guys. It's a lot. This is Sir Jasper Willow. So I'm interested to see, this is kind of cool. You can see exactly who his parents are and everything. That is really, really cool. Marquis Aiden and Rachel of Willow Creek. Oh wait, oh, whoa, what? Okay, I guess I didn't change her last name, so I need to do that? Is he from Willow Creek or is he from Windenburg? We're gonna need to change. I'm gonna need to fix that. That is Sir Jasper. And then here we have, I'm just gonna kind of meet everyone, I guess. Sir Ian, he is the son. Oh, okay, so he's his brother. Sir Jasper and Sir Ian are brothers, so that's good to know. So they're brothers. I don't know if they're from Willow Creek or if they're from Windenburg. I need to find that out. I think they're from Willow Creek. I'm not 100% sure. And then we have, who we have here? Lady Kaylin. So Lady Kaylin is the daughter of Duke Davian Windenburg and Duchess Darcy Windenburg. Okay. I like this, guys. I like being able to see who like their kids are, because if they had kids, that would show up on there too. So I like being able to see who their kids are and who their parents are. So I don't think all of the club members are here, but it looks like some of them went out here to play. So why don't, oh yeah, okay, they just like went on by themselves to go play. So we can also see who all of these are. So Lady Eva or Ava? I know girls with the name Ava, but they spell it E-V-A. So I'm gonna say Ava. I'm pretty sure it's supposed to be Eva, but just because that's what I'm used to, I'm gonna say Ava. She is the daughter of Baron Caleb Willow Creek and Baroness Shauna of Willow Creek. We have Sir Minx, who I think he's also, yeah, okay, they had triplets. So they, Duke Davian and Duchess Darcy, they had triplets. So he's one of them, and I'm assuming this is the other one. I think if his last name is Windenburg, then it's gotta be, because they all have the dark hair. Yep. That's him. Okay, so all three of them are triplets. And yeah, so we are going to, I guess, hang out with them. Who is the group leader here? Sir Minx is the group leader. I think Princess Amira is going to want to be the group leader. Also, what other club perks can we get? We want to be a popular club. Yes, okay. I feel like Princess Amira would also be the type to start her own girls club. She doesn't seem like the type to want to go outside and play all the time. So maybe we could have two different kids clubs. That would kind of be interesting. But then I also like having clubs where it's like all of the cousins. So that way they can all hang out and still get to know each other and build some relationship because they're all related. It's just a lot of clubs that we might be able to have. Oh, I wonder with this mod, can we join more than three clubs? It doesn't look like we can. That's gotta be a mod somewhere though. There's like a mod for almost everything, so I'm sure that is also a mod. So Sir Minx is the leader, so we want to kind of kiss up to him and maybe have him try to let Princess Amira become the leader. So I think this is him walking over here. I don't know how easily that they give into that, but hopefully it will be not too hard, because I really think that Princess Amira would want to be the club leader, because she is just that type of person. It looks like when we invite people, we have to actually click on a child to invite them, because we can't technically invite them from here anymore once we're full, like once we have filled the 8 here. So we'll definitely do that. But right now there's not too many other kids to invite, so I think it's okay for now. What? Is she giving him a gift? Oh my gosh. Princess Amira, you are the worst troublemaker ever. I cannot believe she just did that. Guys, I cannot believe she just really that gained her empathy. Okay, you need to start kissing up more to Sir Minx, because if you want to be the leader, you're going to have to work hard at this. You can't just ask him. Yeah, you can convince him to step down as the club. We can try it once. Oh, right. You guys have to pay the bills, because otherwise they're going to shut off their power. Oh my gosh, those are so expensive. Okay, so I haven't seen... Oh, you can summon Sims. That is going to make my life so much easier. Humanize all aliens, humanize all vampires, deletion cheats, active household cheats, set all walk styles, dresser clean all Sims. What does that do? What does that do? Run clean outfits from MC Dresser on all Sims in the world. Warning, this may take a while if you have a lot of Sims in your world. I don't know what that means. I'll have to look up what that means. Change all outfits, change world time, seasoned cheats. Oh my gosh, this is awesome. Run relationship cleaner, active household. Oh my gosh, guys, I've never seen any of this before. So this is all so new to me. A lot of you probably have already played with this. So you're probably like, yeah, come on, you should know this already. But I don't. This is the first time I've ever downloaded this and it's actually working and I'm so excited. And it's all because it was in some folder that was like actually in the mods folder, but I had to like take them all out of the folder and then put them in the mods folder. It took forever. Another thing I think we're going to do in this episode is age up Princess May, because now all the kids are very close in age. Yeah, because Princess May, it says she has 2 days to age up, and then Prince Kellen has 3 days to age up, and that's just so close to each other. And there's so many other royal little kids that are probably around the same age, but they're not actually the same age. So I think we're going to need to do that. It's just going to be a lot of aging up. And then, oh my gosh, I'm going to have to get so many more kids custom content too, because I really don't think I have that many. She needs to go talk to Sir Minx, and I think he's over here playing on the playground still. Is this him? I don't know. I get him and his brother mixed up. That's Sir Sean. This is Sir Minx. Okay. She's going to join the pirate adventure, and then I'm going to have her convince him to step down as the club leader, and we'll see how that goes. We're also probably going to have to start getting all the arranged marriages. I think this is about the time that the parents would arrange all of the marriages. I feel like probably Princess Amira and Prince Johan would probably be the ones that were going to get together, or the parents would want to get together anyway. So it most likely will be them. But then we also have Princess Belle, so I have to figure out who she would marry. But I feel like there's a lot of options for them. So I think they're all good, because the Oasis Springs family and the Brindleton Bay family, they're related, so they can't marry each other. And the Willow Creek family and the Windenburg family, they're related, so they can't marry each other, but they can marry the other kingdoms. So it's kind of confusing, but I think we got this. I think we are all good. There's like plenty of people for them to marry. It's just, I don't even know what we're going to do with the other kids when they don't get to take over a kingdom. They're going to have to find somewhere else to live. So that is going to definitely be interesting. Also, I think, okay, yeah, I have to travel, because we're not actually going to travel. But I think King Easton passed away. It didn't tell me that he passed away, but I hovered over the royal family of Oasis Springs and he's not there. Guys, he passed away. And I had no idea. Aren't they supposed to tell you stuff like that? I have no idea what happened to him. So apparently they're in mourning. The king of Oasis Springs has just died. So we still have Queen Arya, and I think she still has a good amount of time left to live, so she's still reigning the kingdom. But the family of Oasis Springs, the whole entire kingdom, are probably in a lot of mourning right now, so that is not good. Oh my gosh, what outfit are you wearing? What is this person? She must have just recently aged up into a teenager. I do not know what she's married. I don't know what she's wearing. Oh gosh. Also, the Duchess of Oasis Springs, the one that King Derek of Willow Creek had an affair with, she passed away too. So now we have Duke Addy. He is the Duke of this kingdom now. And then we have Lady Tiara, which is, oh gosh, which is Queen Alice's and Prince Edmund's half-sister. So she's also there too. So she's still a teenager right now, but we should probably go check on them at some point too, maybe pay them a visit. But yeah, we have all the other noble families. They're all starting to age up a lot. We have so many Sims, guys. There's a lot of them everywhere. They're everywhere. Oh my gosh, and we're gonna have to age up the triplets too. That's all going to be at the same time at one point. So we do have a lot. Okay, so we're not actually traveling. I just wanted to show you guys that. So yeah, we have two kind of important Sims that were in our story that passed away. And I didn't even really know about it, which kind of makes me upset. I was just hovering over their households and they were gone. And I was like, that's not the way I wanted to find out, but all right, fine.
Okay, so I think Princess Amira has been playing on here a lot. She's like the only fancy one dressed up. I mean, she's the princess too, so that makes sense, but I feel like we need to change everyone else's outfits. Oh my gosh, and the kids are making a mess out here. So Sir makes, okay, so now we're gonna convince him to step down as the leader and we're gonna see how this goes. Hopefully it goes okay because Princess Amira definitely wants to be the leader of this club. I don't know what he's gonna say though. They're not really that close at all, so. Okay. Oh no, he doesn't look like he's, no. Oh, are you crazy? Oh, he embarrassed her. She is going to, I don't think she'd be happy with him. I think that she would call him names. I think that she's going to not like him at all. This is totally something she would do. I mean, she's hot-headed. So yeah, definitely she would do this. Can you scold her for being mean to another child? Punish? Oh, for being, you can! You can! I think that, would they punish her? She's kind of spoiled, so tell her not to be mean. I think they would do that. I think they're gonna tell her not to be mean. She's losing her empathy. I don't think she would be very empathetic though, given like all the traits that we've given her. So this is kind of, oh gosh, guys, she's not happy. I don't know how much longer she's gonna want to be a part of this club. She'll probably think that like they're lesser than her because they're just noble families. They're not part of any royal families. So she might try to start her own club with just the royal families. But I still want to interact with the noble families too. So I don't want to like separate them so much, but I think she would start her own club. Let me know what you guys think. I think that she would. And then Queen Alice, you're supposed to go scold Princess Amira. Why are you running like that?
Yeah, okay. It's because of it's the fame walk. That's why. That thing takes forever. Witness to a bully. Some kids at school were being mean to one of my friends. I wanted to help, but I didn't know what to do. What do you think I should have done? Step in and stand up for your friend. Stay out of it and console your friends after. You should totally step in and stand up for your friend. Manners decreased. Uh-oh. That's like the one thing. Not that. Well, with the one thing? I mean, they would want their kids to like be good at everything, but manners is like a huge deal for the royal families. I've officially thought that is the most important for sure. Why is it taking her so long to scold her daughter? I feel like she really doesn't want to. This is taking forever. They were out here and they walked back inside and they walked back out here. And this is taking, why? And now you can't scold her? You need to, you have to discipline her. You can't just let that be. You need, she can't anymore. Oh my gosh, you have to teach her to say sorry or something. That is, oh no, did we miss our chance? Princess Amira, you got away with it, Princess Amira. You totally did. All right, well, I think we're going to go ahead now and age up Princess May and Sir Johan. I can't remember who was born first, but we might as well just age up Princess May now since she's right here. Oh, good thing we still have our birthday cake from yesterday. That is super helpful. Is there a cheat that just spawns birthday cakes? Because I think I need that too. All right, I'll just have Princess May ask for help blowing out candles from her mother. Oh man, I didn't get to see see her hair for very long. I really like that hair too. I am excited for her to age up though. This did not last long at all. Let's see. Oh my gosh, you just pushed her through the table. All right. Okay. So Princess May aged up. She got 2 motor, 2 social, 2 creativity, and 1 mental. Her sister had all 2s for all of them, so she only got 1 for mental. So I guess she's definitely more active. So she is going to get the motor aspiration. That sounds strange. Motor aspiration. I think she is going to be, she's a little bit more of a tomboy. So I think I'm going to have her say loves the outdoors. So she's super active. She likes the outdoors, which is the opposite of her sister. Oh my God, what in the world is she wearing? No, I'm not okay with this, guys. This is not okay. Okay. Oh my gosh. All right. Yeah, we're changing your outfit. And then I don't know how much time we have left, but I also need to go age up Sir Johan. So I definitely want to get that in this episode too, because they are the same age. I'm pretty sure they were born at like the same time. What are you wearing? What is this? I just need to like clean this off. Like you need something easy to start with for me to work with. Wow. What are these ridiculous outfits? Clearly, the game also thinks she's a tomboy. She was meant to be a tomboy, but I don't want her hair to be that short. I think it would still be a little bit longer. Guys, I don't really like these eyes. They're very popular, I think, but I don't like them. I like the regular ones a lot more. It might just take me a while to get used to, or maybe I just need to find different eyes, but I don't know. Okay, so she also kind of had the wavy hair. So I think she would keep it more short though. Her hair is really dark. Is her hair always been that dark? Because her mom's hair is that dark? It is that dark. Okay, so she does have her mom's hair. It just looks really, really dark in this. I don't know. Her hair's not curled. Oh my gosh. Oh God, no, that, not that one. Maybe just like this? I feel like this is good for her hair. I don't think it would be super, super short. I think that it would still be like a medium length. And I mean, it's definitely not as long as her sister's, but there's also this one too. That one's pretty. I think I need to change her outfit to be able to like figure out how I feel about this. Okay, I'm not gonna show you guys me picking all this. I'm kind of gonna breeze through this because I also want you guys to see Prince Johan age up as well. Okay, so the outfits that I have chosen for her, I chose 2 different outfits for her everyday wear because even though she's still a tomboy, she doesn't have that much say in the way she's being dressed because she's a princess. So she still needs to kind of follow like the guidelines of the kingdom and all of that. So this is kind of what I chose for her. It's still like proper enough, but it's shorts and it's pants. So I thought that was really cute and good for her. I wish there was a purple version of this, but I don't think there is. But then this is her everyday outfit, her second everyday outfit, which is very, I think it's the exact same thing that she had when she was a toddler. Maybe it was pink when she was a toddler, but I think her color is more purple and then her sister's color is more pink. So that's what I have for her everyday wear. And then this is her formal outfit. She can't really go like too much of a tomboy for her formal outfit. So this is what I have for her. And then I wish this dress was purple though. I don't think there is a purple option for it. There's like that. Yeah, that's not as purple. Yeah, but I think this is good for now. It's purple enough. And then we have her her athletic wear. So this is her athletic wear. She's got her hair up. Then this is her pajamas. And then this is her party outfit. I wish there was more purple. Oh wait, this one. Oh yeah. Okay, no, I like this one better. So this is her her party outfit. And then we have her swimwear. Actually, you know what? I think she's gonna go with one of these for her swimwear. Yeah, that's too blue. I think that's good. Okay, so this is her swimwear. This is her hot weather outfit. And then we also have her winter wear. So she is set. We are good with her. And I think I might find like, try to find other custom content because I'm not too happy about what we had for them. I think I just need more options. I need so many more options and I don't think I have enough. And especially if we're gonna dress all the other kids too, we're gonna need a lot. So with that, let's go ahead and we're gonna rush over to Prince Johan because so far this video, the recording of it is like 45 minutes. So I don't know how long the actual video is gonna be after editing, but hopefully not too long. Okay, so what I'm actually going to try to do is bring this cake over to the royal family of Brindleton Bay, because I don't think we have time to make a cake. So, oh, they're not in Delso Valley. Nope. We also need to check on Princess Anna because we haven't seen her in a while. Okay, so let's try this again. So we need to go to Brindleton Bay and we need to bring this cake over, I guess. Let's just have the whole family come over. I think that is perfectly fine. So, oh my gosh, we have our 2 girls now, guys. I need to get a family picture. I need to. I kind of want to do it before Prince Kellen, before Prince Kellen turns into a child, because he is the youngest. So I think it'd be cute to have his two older sisters and then him as the toddler too. I think that'd be really cute to get a family picture of. Okay, so we're at the Brindleton Bay Palace. We need to knock on the door. Every time I come here, it's just breathtaking. Although it's been nighttime every time I've come here recently, I want to come back in the daytime because this castle is amazing, guys. I love it so much. You know what? I think Princess Amira and Prince Johan would actually be great, because I think Princess Amira, I don't know if this is the first, it's not the first time she's seen this castle, because she's been here when she was a toddler, but this is probably the first time she's seen it and remembering the castle. So I'm imagining her getting here. Oh my gosh, there is a helicopter flying over. I don't actually know if you guys can hear that. Okay, so I'm imagining Princess Amira kind of getting to this castle and just seeing it and being in complete awe of it, because, I mean, let's face it, I'm in complete awe of it every time I see it, and I feel like she would be too. This is totally something that she would want to live in, I feel like. What is happening? What just happened? Did you just change his diaper in the middle of the road? Did he pee on the floor? Oh no, Prince Kellen. So I think we're in the castle. So we need to, I guess, just put this cake out on the table. And then I'll see if we're able to do this. Oh wait, can I not? Oh, it must be in the center of the table. Okay, maybe I can't do it on a coffee table. Where is their kitchen table? I can put it on a counter. Let's do that. Let's put it in the center of the counter, and then there we go. All right, so we need to add those birthday candles. Okay, and then I have to see if she can actually age up the baby, if she can bring, let's see, help blow out candles. No, can we not age up Prince Johan? I think we're just going to have to, wait, let's see. Okay, Prince James, Prince Johan, can we age him up at all? Do we have to introduce ourselves? Is that why? We can do that. Express love, friendly introduction. Okay, so Queen Alice is supposed to be introducing herself to Prince Johan. I've asked her to do this like a bunch of times. Why is he angry? Is it because his diaper smells? Are you introducing yourself to him yet? She is. She's like automatically really good friends with him. That's so strange. Okay, can I age him up now? Oh wait, did I move the cake? I did. The cake went bad. Guys, the cake went bad. I have the worst luck. All right, I have to make another cake. Okay, Queen Alice just made this cake. So, oh my gosh, this better go well. I have the worst luck with birthday cakes. It's crazy. Okay, help blow out candles. Yes, I can bring Prince Johan now. I guess you have to be friends with them to be able to bring them to the cake. So I guess that kind of makes sense. Okay, he is blowing out the candles. He is going to be a child too. I'm excited. Oh my gosh. Okay, so we can't pick his traits because we're not playing as their household. And I don't think I'm going to have him. I'm not going to change his outfits right now because we do need to end this episode. So in the next episode, I will show you guys the outfits I picked for them. We might even have Princess Amira and Prince Johan hang out together a little bit more. I think the parents would get together, or the families would get together and try to get their kids together and see if they like each other. So I'm going to end this episode here, but I hope you guys enjoyed this. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and turn on your notifications. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and leave in the comments any suggestions that you have as well. And I will see you guys the next episode.